Hello and welcome to Switzerland, Lake Lungern. Of course, there are worse places in the world to spend your time, but today we'll be driving around the lowlands of the Swiss Alps and showing you typical town in Switzerland, maybe even a few waterfalls, okay? Let me just take a little look for yourself. It almost looks like a postcard. Absolutely beautiful. Okay, let's go and check out the car. Okay, I'm proud to introduce you to your Mercedes CLA, full leather interior LED lighting that makes, call it ambient lighting. It's quite relaxing, especially for nighttime drives. If you want to just take a quick look around, let's get you into the car. Welcome to Switzerland, and in typical Swiss fashion, we've had the most delicious hot chocolate prepared for you, made with a touch of fresh cream and a little bit of spice. Okay, it's for you. Of course, along with all your treats, popcorn, candies, two very warm blankets, and a pillow. Okay, so today we'll be driving around the Alps. We might even get as high to the point that we're driving in the clouds, depending on the cloud level. It's one of these mystical and almost ethereal moments. We'll also introduce you to a typical Swiss village. And how beautiful the grass is here. It's like the most luscious green ever. I'll also provide you with a 30-40 minute commentary, again via my lapel mic, explaining a little bit about Switzerland and all its many incredible attributes. From there, we'll be driving again. If you get tired, grab the pillow, get the blanket, and just enjoy. We might see a little bit of rain, so if you enjoy rain sounds on the roof and the window, then we all have all that to look forward to. So sit back and enjoy. Okay, let's get started. Okay, good. Now let's just test the mics. This should be your left ear, and this should be your right ear. Since your last outing with us, we've upgraded the lapel mics, now running dual. And if you look just across the window there, you'll be met with Lake Lungern. And of course, again, I'd like to welcome you to Switzerland, and I hope you enjoy the purring of the Mercedes CLA. As we approach this junction, we'll be making a right turn and making our way adjacent to Lake Lungern. And
This lake in particular is one of 7,000 lakes in Switzerland. And perhaps the turquoise color, the beautiful mountain backdrop, makes for a very typical Swiss lake. The greens, that verdant green that is again very typically Swiss, and we're actually making our way towards a little town. And Lungern is a municipality of Obwalden. We'll make our way down the outskirts of the lake. Make our way through the little town, and then we'll drive around a very typical mountain village of Switzerland. Something almost postcard-esque about Switzerland, especially Obwalden. And if you ever find yourself in Switzerland, or coming back, I should say, Obwalden should be somewhere you consider spending a couple of days at least. As we enter the town, this is again very typically Swiss. These are traditional Swiss houses, and some of these houses will be more than 250, maybe even 300 years old. Sundays on Switzerland is considered a day of complete rest. It's considered rude to be working, to be cutting grass, maintenance, all these kind of things. And if you just look to your right here, you'll see a little outstretch from the river. And I encourage you tomorrow to have a little walk around it. It's a beautiful spot with benches and the most wonderful view. See the mountain dressed in that low-hanging cloud. And hopefully, as we mentioned earlier, we'll actually be driving through some of this low-lying cloud. Now, just in a minute or so, we'll approach a rather beautiful Catholic church. And it's quite a stark contrast, these houses, cars, streetlights. And again, looking to your right, this backdrop of Mother Nature. These mountains are millions and millions of years old. In the distance there, you can just see the church. This is a very quiet town. And the bakery on the left there sells particularly good pastries. Here we can see the church. Really quite magnificent. Something, again, quite wonderful. With the backdrop of yet another mountain. As I mentioned, there's 7,000 mountains in Switzerland. All of which seem to just sit there, ageless and timeless. As we make our way down into this little grassy village, you can see how they're all laid out. And amongst this impossibly green grass, and even on a cloudy day like today, and maybe we'll be lucky and hear some raindrops later, but even on this cloudy day, the green with the stark contrast of the wooded mountains seems almost too beautiful to believe. And sometimes it's nice just to be quiet and take this quiet serenity in. The little boats moored. And in this particular town, almost everything is communal. Communal fishing boats, communal fire pits all around the outside of the lake. There's a real sense of community here. And some of the most delicious cured meats and cheese you'll ever, ever taste. Now, if you can just see in the distance, that's actually a waterfall. A waterfall. Trickling down the side of this tens of millions of year old mountain. Look at the green. So, so pretty. Impossibly green. It's almost as if you're looking at a postcard that's been photoshopped. And we trek back to this beautiful waterfall. And driving amongst such scenery is an honor and something I consider to be very fortunate. Beautiful trees, rock, and this elegant waterfall. It might not come as a surprise that Switzerland has been voted one of the most beautiful countries in the entire world. And as you're casually driving your way through, you can probably see why. It's a quiet town. Everyone's resting. Everyone's at ease. The grass is not too dissimilar from something of a hobbit from Lord of the Rings. These grassy kind of knolls and pastures. Although, it might surprise you. It might look similar, but Lord of the Rings wasn't filmed in Switzerland. Though it might not be host to Lord of the Rings, Switzerland has actually won most innovative country in the entire world every single year since 2011. But still, while maintaining all of this natural beauty, just look at these mountains, separated only by the lake. And that's actually a cable car that you can see running above your head. I encourage you to check it out tomorrow. Again, the low-lying cloud, adding a majestic touch. Sheer size and enormity. You can see the church there in the background. Have no fear, we actually see some people. Although they look like tourists. Probably doing something similar to what you're doing, just in a little bit less style. I hope the car is comfortable, by the way. I appreciate it's not the Jaguar that you're accustomed to, but we're in the German-speaking area of Switzerland, so it seemed only right to be using a German car. Speaking of which, Switzerland is home to three predominant languages. German makes up a little more than 50%, closer to 60%. Then French, and then Italian, and a little Romani as well, actually. But here in Obwalden, it's almost entirely exclusively German-speaking. Of course, restaurants, bakeries, most speak English. But all the signs, instructions are in German. Now we're making a right turn as we came out of the little village, and we're going to begin our climb up the mountain. And you might have seen postcards, movies of cars going up these long zigzag roads that seem to wrap around the mountain. Well, that's exactly what we're going to be doing today. And as we make our way through, again, this beautiful woodland trail, these little houses scattered around, engulfed in cloud. To go back to my point, it's easy to understand why Switzerland continues to win most innovative country in the world. They've maintained this beautiful nature and spent 16 billion Swiss francs every year on research, specializing in human resource systems, developing intellectual assets, and more recently, they've established the crypto valley in Zug, near Zurich. People are calling this the Silicon Valley equivalent, and billions of pounds, francs, are being generated in this new crypto valley. And again, culture seems to sit at the heart of Switzerland. And just looking to your left there, it's easy to understand why the Swiss are so proud of being Swiss. And again, Switzerland was founded on the idea of having creativity, individualism, and equality to all. Of course, Switzerland is centrally located for trade, and although it's extremely wealthy as a nation, it's actually very, very small. California, the state alone, is 10 times the size of Switzerland. And it only has a population of 9 million. And 25% of these 9 million are actually foreign. And these 9 million individuals enjoy a very high quality of life. Switzerland continually ranks very, very high for quality of life. Large amounts of money is invested in education, in the medical field. Citizens can expect to be well cared for. Kids can be well educated. Streets are immaculately clean. There's no graffiti. No sign of decline. And as we make our way down this little hill, you'll notice as we continue to drive, it's a common theme to go down a little bit and then rise back up. But rest assured, we are actually climbing the Alp. Right now, though, we're just making our way there. I don't even see a car or two along the way. There are a lot of these little towns dotted throughout Obwalden. Little hamlets of only 100 or so people. And almost all of them have a restaurant at the heart that serves the most delicious food. And even here, this isn't mist that you're looking at. This is actually cloud. If we were at a lower elevation looking up, our car would look like it was in cloud, just at the edge there of the road. And while one of these delicious restaurants sits at the middle of every hamlet, Switzerland is actually the least obese country in all of Europe. It's a very healthy nation, despite having a love of chocolate, meat, and cheese. Can't just look into your left and breathtaking cloud and the sun shining through the trees. It looks almost ethereal. And this right here is why we wanted to offer the sleep service in Switzerland. Nice leather chairs, the blanket, some snacks, hot chocolate, and just to sit back all cozy and warm inside and look out at pure beauty. And rest assured, there is a lot to see, a lot more. Enjoy. Now, as you might remember, I am a huge foodie myself, but I will say that meat is one of the most expensive products in all of the world in Switzerland. And this is very purposeful, because any meat that's imported has an incredibly high taxation, which encourages and supports local farmers and producers, helping to ensure Switzerland's own economy thrives. And again, despite the love of chocolate and cheese, life expectancy in Switzerland is also enormously high, and one of the highest in the world. And it also has the highest percentage of people over 100 years old in all of Europe. And if I remember correctly, the Swiss have the second highest life expectancy, only behind Japan, who, of course, their diet is exemplary. It's a very low rate of poverty, thankfully, in Switzerland. And as we make a few of these tighter turns, we can take a moment to appreciate the road architecture and infrastructure. All of the roads are impeccably maintained. And bear in mind that Switzerland sees some of the coldest winters imaginable for road surfaces. And all of them are perfectly maintained. They're not cracked, no potholes. A real comfort to drive in, actually. You might not know this, but history states that Albert Einstein was actually studying in Bern. My wife and I were there a couple of days ago, but he was studying in Bern when he penned the famous E=mc² formula. As we just stop at these lights and look at the length of the tree, can't even see the base, but they're incredibly tall, quite thin. And it's said that the wood in Obwalden has some of the finest timber, the strongest wood. And of course, the houses are made with this very wood. And as we just make our way through the traffic lights, reminded just how small we really are compared to the giant forest. It's incredibly fortunate that we can just weave our way through the little strip of tarmac. Almost like a little carousel or a roller coaster, going very slowly, taking you on a sightseeing tour, the likes of which people can only ever dream of. The mountains of Switzerland would never be forgotten once seen. As we make our way back down, we're met by the cloud. And this little village that sits, as always, at the foot of a breathtaking mountain. And it's almost a bit surreal that people are just living here in this postcard-like view. As if it's completely normal. As if living here isn't beyond the average person's wildest dream. And we're still very high up. That's why the cloud is just above these houses. It might not seem like it, but combined with a little bit of low-lying cloud, well, I could sit and look at it all day. Especially with a nice cup of coffee. Something to snack on. Almost exactly your scenario. And everything in Switzerland is really quite uniform. As you pass through villages that here you can see everything is perfectly sectioned off. Grass is always cut. Interestingly enough, the grass is actually cut by cows that are rotated between each field. The only fields that I'm aware of that they don't eat are the ones directly adjacent to a road. But a farmer that I have never seen, I'm assuming there's more than one, is ushering these cows from field to field, keeping the grass short, and the cow is very, very happy. And they make some of the tastiest milk you're ever likely to experience. Now we're going to take a little left turn here. And as we exit the village, we'll really begin to make our ascent into the cloud. And it's at that point I'll switch the mics off and leave you to your thoughts. But not quite yet. An average town life, the average life of a Swiss, despite having an incredibly high standard of living, the finest foods, the Swiss themselves like to travel also and see the world. I suppose if you've grown up here and it's all you've ever known, you can't blame them for wanting to see more of the world. But just look at it. There's a gorgeous mountain just behind these houses. The road is paved with beautiful trees. Life here is just serene. And it might surprise you, but there aren't that many tourists this far north from what we had seen. Places like Obwalden aren't necessarily the number one place people think to go when traveling to Switzerland. Everyone wants to see Zurich and the shopping. if you can make your way out here a little bit, it might be a simpler, quieter life. And if you're looking for nightclubs and bars and parties, and who is, because let's be honest, we're all antisocial, but somewhere like this might be what you're looking for. And there are an array of beautiful trains, cable cars, and if you've ever seen social media, you might have seen these little roller coasters, single person roller coasters that make their way down the mountain. It's incredibly fun. And you can see the sun breaking through the cloud there, making for a spectacular view. Really take a moment to appreciate what you're looking at. Later we can maybe get out the car and have a little walk around, so you can really breathe in that mountain air. Because it really is. These mountains were here long, long before you and I, and they will remain here long, long after. And it always is quite humbling to remind ourselves when we're worried about how much money we have, what kind of car we drive, our next exam, our next promotion, our next phone call. These worry a lot of people. We worry about all these things, and our life is a speck in comparison to these millions of year old mountains. But for right now, we're here experiencing and witnessing. And while life might be quick, right now it's slow. It's slow. And we're in no rush. And we can revisit this moment whenever we choose to come back to Switzerland and be driven around the fastness. Thousands of lakes, and curiously, the longest tunnel in the entire world is actually in Switzerland. I have driven through it, and we won't go through it today. It's 57 kilometers long under the ground. Surreal. You can see now we're just starting to climb a little bit. And the road never gets unnervingly steep. Though rest assured, if it did, the Mercedes will power effortlessly through. And while we don't use this particular car for speed or power, it's comforting to know it's there if needed. And just look as we make our way around this snaking road, once again declining before our final ascent. Little doorbells. Imagine having to share an entire bus with people when you have your very own car. Again, those twin mountains. Beautiful. Effortless. And that little village, this is a different village. It might look similar to what we passed prior, but it's the other side of the mountain. And these long slowly and gently, allowing you to absorb these views and look at it with the sun on the right, that vibrant green, and the three mountains. Just remarkable. I'm so glad that you're here to experience it. Because many people in life will never get to do this, will never get to sit and gaze upon what you're gazing at right now. And it's one of the most beautiful natural phenomena in the world. And again, some people will just never see it. But look at it, that green, the beautifully built wooden houses. This. Switzerland. Truly, truly remarkable. Well, I keep mentioning it. It's impossibly green, the grass. If I hadn't been here, assume it was photoshopped. It looks too green, too perfect. And look at that shot. The little house, all on its own, the white, is on the hill, looking over the town that sits behind us now. Look at the size of those mountains. Dwarf these little towns. And while we might be small, we don't need size of a mountain to make our difference. Make our way over a little bridge. Of course, there's a stream running underneath. And why wouldn't there be? We're in Switzerland. And as we exit this town, we will be passing a little board that explains all the different heights we're about to traverse. And at this point, I'm going to step back from the microphone. And from this point on, all the beauty is yours. Stated. Just how it feels driving through a cloud in around 10 minutes or so. And it might not seem like we are. Again, if you were to view a cloud from a distance, they look quite thick. But when you're inside a cloud, it's quite wispy and obviously we have visibility to drive, but it's still quite surreal. And we'll stop the car, as I said, and you can get out and have a little walk around and just think to yourself you're inside a cloud. Look at that shot. Simply we get higher. Of course, Mercedes has zone control, climate control. So if you like to get a bit warmer, feel free to increase the temperature. Or grab your blanket, both blankets, and instead of getting the car a bit hotter, you can just get a bit cozier. Something quite adventure-like about that. Knowing it's cold outside and it's warm inside the car. Nice and safe. And you just lay back and let your eyes do the work. And if your eyes start to get a little heavy, then feel free to close them. Okay. If you need me for anything, I'll be here. We'll climb up, have a little walk around, continue the climb up to one of my favorite spots. It's a restaurant, actually. And then we'll drive behind the restaurant up to what's called the Glacier View. It's a very old lake. And we'll turn around and come down, passing the lake again. As you can see, the road begins to snake almost entirely and exclusively up now. So sit back. Get comfortable. And please, enjoy the sleep service. Good night. Good night. And thank you.
Okay, so we're now actually at cloud level. So I'll come around and you can get out and have a look around. We'll go up a little bit further yet, but it's nice just to look around almost like inside a cloud. It is quite cold out there because we are very, very high, but very beautiful nonetheless. We're going to go a little bit higher, and then we'll make our way and come back down, okay?